Welcome to another class for Yoga with Joy. Today again, we will be mostly doing some intermediate poses. It will be a full body workout, so let's get started. Stand at the top of the mat. In Parvatasana. Relax your shoulders. Your back bend, fold forward, look up, step or hop back, up dog, down dog, right leg up, right leg forward, left leg forward, forward fold, get up one vertebra at a time, stretch your side. Full body stretch. Forward fold again. Step or hop back. Up dog. Down dog. Right leg up. Right leg forward. Let's come to low lunge. Low lunge twist. Prayer twist. Lift your back leg up. Bring your torso up. Come to neutral. Bring your hands down, come to plank. Down low. Left leg up. Left leg forward. Come to low lunge. Low lunge twist. To prayer twist. Bring your back leg up. Torso up. You can add a back bend, but add a back bend and then neutral. Bring your arms down to plank. Right leg to right arm. Right leg to your nose. Right leg to your left arm. One more time. Right leg to right arm. Right leg to nose. Right leg to left arm. You can repeat it three more times or try to come to an arm balance. Come back to plank. Let's do the other side. Left leg to left arm, to nose, to right arm. Left leg to left arm, to nose, to right arm. Now either you can repeat it three more times or try to do an arm balance with me. Back to plank. From plank, we will try to go to, what is the name of the leg? Eagle leg. And then rotate ourselves to come to Vasistasana. Turn back and then slowly come to a standing. Standing, then bring your right hand on top and have eagle arms as well, and then squeeze in your eagle pose, And then slowly come back. Bring your leg down, which will bring us to seated spinal twist. Plank again and repeat it on the other side. So do the opposite leg. And then a variation of Bhastasana. Turn back. Now come back to a standing pose with eagle leg. Arm to standing. Opposite arm on top. Squeeze in your eagle. Come back up. Let's gently come down. Unwind your legs. Stack your knee one on the top of the other. And do a seated twist. Cool. So from here, come to neutral tabletop. Neutral tabletop to cat cow, breathe in. Cat with a cow. Cat cow. Cat cow. Opposite leg, opposite arm. And then bind and stretch. Bring it down. Opposite leg, opposite arm. Bind and stretch. Bring it down. Arm to chest. Now we'll come to some experimental poses, which is dolphin pose, which is not so much experimental. From there, we'll go to scorpion. So we are in dolphin. And you can stay in dolphin. If you want to try, claw your floor and then just do a couple of hops. Some more hops. Come to plank pose and we'll do some hip dips. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Cool. Now, let's do some back bend. So we'll do Ustrasana. You can also have your arm in prayer pose. Gently come up. One more time. To a malasana. From malasana, stand up. And then come onto this posture, which is almost like chair pose, but your legs are open. So we'll do some lion spread here. Have your arms fisted up, and then look. Breathe in, ha, breathe in, ha, breathe in, ha. This is particularly very energizing for me. I don't know, it gives me like a lot of courage. I think we need, all of us need it during this pandemic. All right,
done with that. But now we'll come to, you can probably tell from my legs, God's pose. One toe, beyond one leg, toe of right leg, toe of the other leg, now beyond both. Bring it down, stretch your one shoulder, stretch your other shoulder. Come to star pose. From here, we'll bend forward so you can intertwine your fingers. And I don't know if you can figure it out, that I'm trying to keep my spine completely straight and bent forward. Bring your hands down, both hands down, and then bring one hand to the center and open the other side. Bring it down, open the other side. Bring it to center. Hold it in. If you have tripod practice, go for it. My neck is feeling slightly weird today, so I'm not doing that. Instead, I'm letting my head hang to decompress my neck. All right. Bring yourself up slowly. Bring your hand in prayer pose, and then without bending this leg, keep this leg straight, come to side plank. Come up, side plank. When you get up also, see how this leg is not bending, staying completely straight. Okay. Now face forward. Come to low lunge and we'll try to go to half Hanuman or full Hanuman depending on where you want. So if you want to be in half Hanuman, this is your half Hanuman and you can stay here. If you want to try full Hanuman, try to have your arms on both sides and using that as leverage, push your front leg forward and see if you can come to a full Hanumanasana. Gently come out. Let's do the other side. So, at that half Hanuman, we'll stay here. Or we'll try full Hanuman. Now we'll come back to Malasana. Remember how we did it before as well? Keeping our spine straight. And now we'll do crow pose. Again, you can just rock in your crow and don't need to actually go to crow. Or like lift one leg at a time. effort are poured out.
Remember?
First goes for core vena.
It's usually both goes. Add some side crunches.
And make your leg in diamond position.
Reclining. Supta Baddha.
Let's do some more cores with leg lifts.
Come down on your back, lift your leg. You can add some cushion by putting your back of your hand on the bottom of your hips, and then 30, 60, 90. Bring it up. 30, 60, 90. Bring it up. 30, 60, 90. 90 is hovering though, you don't touch that. Six, seven, eight, nine. 10. Come on to your belly now.
Be on your any of your cheek,
and then lift your leg up, lift your arm up, and lift your head up. Then the opposite cheek on the ground. Now let's hold our leg and try to lift up and be on our belly.
Spread your arms out and then we are going to do shoulder stretch by rotating. Come back to center and then open the other side. Come back to center and then get up. Depending on how much time we have, can we do some seated poses now? Seated poses, let's first come to Dandasana. In Dandasana, we'll fold. Come to half lotus and then recline on your extended leg. Come on. Take this one out to the other side. intermediate class, so I do want to give you guys some interesting poses that you can try and practice. So come up in your legs like this. Don't open it too wide because the pose I'm gonna show, it's harder when your legs are wider. So put your hand on either side of your leg and then use your core, like hold your core like crazy and do a lift. Breathe in. So you can do one leg at a time, you see, one leg. Lift the other leg. You can face this and lift the other leg. Or engaging your core, you can try lifting both your legs. Since we are already in an open leg position, come and fold in the front. Let's do some side stretches. Putting your arm opposite thigh and then stretch yourself. Come back. Let's do the other side. Your arm under your knees and bring it close. Then we will do some spinal twists. We did some spinal twists at the beginning of the class. We'll do some more. Maybe you can bind if you want to keep it slightly different than the first one we did. We'll stack our knees, strive to do Gomukhasana, bind our arms, and lean forward. Bring it up. Let's do the other side. So we'll do a Gomukhasana and then the spine. Bring this knee a little up so we can use this as a leverage to do a twist. Now let us go to pigeon pose. Right leg up, right leg forward. Come to sit up. You can try binding your leg with your arm. I'm gonna try doing a king pigeon. Your shin parallel to the mat. Back to dumbbell.
Left leg up.
Left leg forward. Come to a seated pigeon. You can bind if you want. Otherwise, you can just not bind. It's also fine. downscale pigeon. Slightly challenging for me. That's why I try time to time and then
we come to recline.
Bridge pose. Go on to your bridge. Let's come to a wheel if wheel is in our practice. Otherwise, do one more bridge. Come down gently. Right leg on top of left. Arms extended, come to a supine twist, look opposite side. Come back to center. Do the other leg. Come back to center. A gentle inversion. We did do a leg, right? So if you feel like you can come to a shoulder stand. Set a heel. Come to Halasana. Gently come out of Halasana. If you want, you can come to a fish pose, which is bringing yourself on top of your head and raising your chest up. Gently come out, unwind your legs. Come to happy baby. Make baby noises, extend your leg. To Savasana. Come to your favorite side. My fetal pose. Gently come out. Come to a comfortable seated position. Let's close our practice with like round of 20 couple of bhatis. So breathe in and forcefully breathe out using your belly. For making it to the class. See you guys tomorrow.